Hello everybody, welcome to G4G here on YouTube. I'm your host, Dave Pondon, and we are taking a look at the newest hero in Heroes of the Storm. He is a human Worgen, known as Greymane. Now if you may remember, the first day that Lunara came out, we briefly had a little bit of this opening cinematic in the background for her, and then it went away very quickly. And then went over to Lunara, so this is pretty much what we saw that first day. Let's go ahead and take a look at him. He has a bundle in the store that includes himself in his normal skin, and also has a Ringmaster skin. He comes with a mount that is a lion. Would be a really cool lion if it wasn't for that stupid feather up top. That feather kind of ruins it, and the girlfriend said it's a little bit of a derp line that he's cross-eyed. I haven't been able to tell. Also, unfortunately for the general populace, Cho'Gall is now up for sale, which is kind of sad because it has introduced a lot of very bad Cho'Galls hanging out there, which kind of sucks. So let's take a look into Greymane. So when you first get to his page, you can do his human form or his Worgen form. And let's take a look at the skin. So on his stock, he's got this. He's got a red, which makes him look really evil. The eyes get very red. Looks almost Dracula-ish. And there's his Worgen form. Here's his final color on his stock, so a very pale Worgen. And kind of a very old-looking Greymane in his human form. What's very interesting is this kind of reminds me of the Son of Argal. The Son of Argal, if you've never played World of Warcraft, was a bit of a scourge. He was a very high-level elite mob that hung around a undead area. I think it was like 23, and most of the times you encountered him, you were somewhere between 10 and 18. So the Son of Argal was known as quite a big deal back in the day. Here's his master skin. It's a little vampire hunter-ish, a little Van Helsing with that hat. And of course his logo is up there. It's the Greymane logo. And there's his Worgen form. Very nice armor on him. Shoulder epaulettes. There's the middle color, again with the red. The eyes get very, very red. Looks like a nice blood tinge. And there's his colors again. He gets a very white beard. And there's his final form. Pretty similar to one of the Vala-looking outfits. And there's his Worgen as a master. Sort of gives him a very furry color. And by furry, I mean the people, furries. So here is his store skin. If we look at him over here, there's his ringmaster. Looks very, very circus-like. Nice amount of detail in this one. Here's his middle one. Going with that green, red, green, orange motif. But if you look at his gun over here, it almost looks like a fake gun, a toy gun. Like there's kind of like a plunger on it. And there's his Stars and Stripes. Now, the first thing that I think of when I see this is Apollo Creed from the Rocky movies. It reminds me of one of Apollo's very early outfits that makes a return back in Rocky IV when he really ramps it up and is about ready to fight Ivan Drago. And, of course, we know what happens there. And there is his final Ringmaster form. The Worgen, as you can see in the Ringmaster form, it turns him into a lion to go with the mount. I didn't get the bundle on this one, but if I do reach the level that I could use his final skin, I may get this just to go Stars and Stripes. It does look kind of cool. His abilities are a Gilneas cocktail, damages the first enemy hit and deals heavy damage behind them. This is very good early in the game, as it's going to mess people up. You throw the cocktail at the lead of a minion wave, where generally the hero is behind it, so as not to get a lot of early damage done. And it does some pretty good damage if you are actually not the target. Later on, you can definitely wreck somebody's face for about a third to close to a half. You know, maybe three-fifths of their health if you if they're in the back line when you throw a cocktail. You get Inner Beast, which is kind of like Raynor's attack speed. He gives it to himself, and he attacks faster in either form for 3 seconds. However, basic attacks refresh the duration, so he can keep it up for a long time, provided he has targets to hit. And yes, banging away at a wall on the enemy side will definitely keep that going. And there are some talents that rope into the Inner Beast. We have Dark Flight, which in human form turns him into a Worgen and dashes at somebody. Very Illidan-esque. Curse of the Worgen is his trait. When you are a human, your basic attack is ranged. When you are a Worgen, your basic attack is melee, but it deals 40% more damage. I have found that I've tended to be more in human form as a kind of a backline poker, and then I go Worgen for the kill. So believe it or not, it's almost backwards. My Worgen is my sniper, and my human form is kind of my farmer. I so far have always gone for go for the throat. I haven't done anything else yet, but I did have one Greymane use Mark for the Kill on me. You leap at the enemy hero and you shapeshift into Worgen form, slashing 3 times for damage. If it kills them, the ability can be used a second time within 10 seconds for free. By the way, this requires expert timing. It really means that the ability has to get the kill to get the free slash. It is sometimes good and sometimes a curse. I have used it effectively several times. It is somewhat like Artanis' laser retargeting. Marked for the Kill, which has the same amount of cooldown, you shapeshift into a human form, and you fire a shot hitting the first enemy hero for 68 damage. For 5 seconds, they are vulnerable, taking 25% more damage. If you reactivate this, you leap at them and shapeshift into Worgen form. Now, when you're in Worgen form, your razor swipes forward and you damage enemies. Your Inner Beast, again, does speed. Your Dark Flight disengages you. You roll in a direction. It's not necessarily away. You just roll. Much like Leoric's Wraithwalk, you can actually use this to roll forward. In the last 2 matches that I've done, I've begun to use this as a form of aggression by disengaging towards people and finishing them off with a well-placed cocktail. Don't just think of disengage as getting out of dodge. Think of it as, you know, completing kills. Unfortunately, and this is something that I kind of wasn't exactly too sure on in the early ability videos that Blizzard was putting out and whatnot, you can only go into your opposing form by the E ability and the heroic. So what'll happen is if you're like farming a lane and everything and you want to go into a Worgen, you actually have to have a target for your E so that you jump at it and the jump causes the transformation. When you are a Worgen, however, you don't need a target for disengage. Just hit it, and you'll flip out. I kind of, in a way, don't like that. I wish I had an easier way of transforming into a werewolf without having a target. The reason being is that if you are in the Worgen form, and you're doing stuff, and you're like, I don't know where the enemy team is, they may be coming my way, I want to go ahead and be in Worgen so that I could disengage out and just, you know, roll out of the way a little bit. You need a target. So be prepared for that. You could get out of Worgen form very easily, but you get into it not as easy. So there is his basic overview. for talents at level 1, Wolfheart, Perfect Aim, Scented Tincture, Viciousness. Wolfheart, basic attacks, lower inner beast cooldown. So if basically you activate this and you auto shot while your Gilneas thing is, you know, cooling down, it's actually better in human form for this one because your swipe is up a little bit quicker than your cocktail. But, you know, if it's the beginning of the match and you're out in the lane and you throw a cocktail and you activate your W and you're shooting, just auto-attacking, you can get this ability when it expires to be back up in as low as 4 seconds. When you don't do it effectively, it could be a fairly long cooldown. Your W is refreshed as long as you are doing damage in some way, shape, or form. This ability allows just simple basic attacks to drop the cooldown when it actually is done. Perfect Aim, your cocktail range is increased by 30% and it refunds mana if it hits a hero. I have never picked this. I did see one Greymane go a potion build. Scented Tincture, Gilneas cocktail reveals enemy heroes for 10 seconds. This is positively vicious for stealthers. 10 seconds is long. The problem is, be prepared. It's not as easy to use it as you think. Early on, the only time you get splash is if this hits a target. So if you're out in a lane and nothing is around you and you see a sparkle and you know like Zeratul's coming up to you, you can't really throw this at him and have him hit it and it'll, you know, it'll expose him and you're like, oh, I'm going to go in on him before he goes hit on me. If he was behind a minion wave and you threw this at the minions and it splashed and hit him, it works. Don't be afraid to pick it because later on there is a talent that helps this and makes this actually into something useful. Viciousness increases inner beast duration abilities refresh. So your inner beast duration goes up to 4 seconds if you were sitting around doing nothing. And ability damage also causes it to refresh. So instead of just your basic doing it, see, basic attacks refresh the duration. Viciousness allows, like, the cocktail or whatever to keep it going. Now, if you were farming in Worgen form and like Worgen better, you might like Viciousness better because then that means your swipe can help you keep it going. But when it expires, you will always face the maximum cooldown, which, as you can see, is 16 seconds. Here at level 4, Thick Skin, Dark Flight reduces damage taken from basic attacks. Using Dark Flight, meaning from human into Worgen, reduces the damage of the next two heroic basic attacks made against you while you're in Worgen. Very good if you like to engage and be in there for melee. It's kind of like Hardened Bones for Leoric. Next two is pretty solid, and it doesn't mention a timer, so it looks like it would be stored until two auto attacks hit you. Probably good if you want to go in on a Vala or maybe like a Sonya and everything. Eyes in the Dark, disengage grants stealth for 4 seconds. I like this one a lot. Pretty good if you can roll into smoke and lose people. I often pick this one. Inner Beast causes basic attacks to restore 5 mana up to 20. This one is pretty good. I like this a lot as it gives him mana sustain. He has no sustain at all for hit points, but this helps him go with a bit of a nice mana restore, and I can definitely farm pretty easily with this one. I tend to go one of these two all the time. I've never done any of the others. Draught Overflow increases Gilneas Cocktail's explosion length by 35%. So this is the splashback. I haven't seen this one yet, but I can definitely see how a potion build would be good, especially if you did the revealing one. Here, increases human basic attack range, Quicksilver Bullets. Incendiary Elixir increases the damage on impact and always explodes. This is the one that really makes the Scented Tincture worthwhile, because now even if you just threw it on the ground You know, if you were like a quarterback spiking a football, you're like, oh shit, I'm going to get sacked. Boom, throw it right on the ground. This is where this is helpful, and it makes the stealth revealing talent very good, because now if you do see a stealther coming up to you, and you just threw it in their general direction, it will splash, and it will more likely hit them. So this gives value to that. Wizened Duelist, hero takedowns increase basic attack damage by 3% to a maximum of 30 is lost on death. So this is kind of like his gathering power. I just haven't done this yet because I really do like this and the fact that I can always make my stuff explode even if I miss. This may be pretty decent. I've always gone for go for the throat over here. I haven't done mark for the kill yet. A little bit more mana on go for the throat, identical cooldowns. Running wild, increases dark flight and disengages range by 35%. I like this one. It's good for engage, good for getting out. And, you know, if you're a human and you're running away, you can kind of be a Karazim and dark flight into minions to get you on the right path and then keep running away, keep running away. And since you're a Worgen, the next time you use your W is a rollout. So you could definitely get out of a lot of trouble with this one. Basic attacks reduce Razor Swipe's cooldown by a second. Since I'm not often in Worgen form, I've never picked this one yet. On the prowl, Inner Beast increases your movement speed by 30% once it's activated, and it lasts 3 seconds. Haven't done this one yet. Unfettered Assault, Razor Swipe lunges Greymane 60% further, but its cooldown is increased by 33%. Haven't done that one yet either. But it's not really going to add that much to the cooldown. I think it's only really going to add a second. Concentrated Blast. The cocktail damage is ramped up by 80% when Inner Beast is active. That's your haste. Reduces the duration of silences, stuns, and slows. And polymorphs against you when you're in Worgen form. Executioner. Against slowed, rooted, or stunned targets. I haven't gone this one yet because he doesn't really have any stuns or anything. Because if we look at his Razor Swipe, he has no stuns. So, I don't know. I think they could do better than Executioner. I mean, if you had a stun comp with you. But a lot of other people who have Executioner have a way of doing their own extra damage, like Vala. Alpha Killer. Worgen basic attacks against heroes deal bonus damage equal to 3% of their health. So this is his Giant Killer. I've always done this one. A potion bill would obviously go concentrated blast. I have done this one a few times. This changes your lead in a little bit. You would activate your haste, then throw a cocktail, and then do your auto attacks. At 20, unleashed, a free kill, a free cast also gives you a free cast if you get a kill. So, if you're facing three people and you kill the one on your heroic, it's free. If you kill the second one with your heroic, you get a final cast and can go after the third person. I've tended to always pick this. Mark for the kill pierces heroes. Mark for the kill passes through enemy heroes, making all of them vulnerable and allowing leap to be used on each marked target at once. So this one could be pretty interesting. This one could get super pouncy. 100 Blunderbuss. Human basic attacks splash for 100% damage behind the target, so it makes his auto like his cocktail. And basic attacks cleave for 100% damage. I have done none of those so far. Alright, so what we're going to do is we're going to pause it. I'm going to get into a match with him, and you get to see him in action. So starting off, looking at the enemy team, they have a Greymane, a Brightwing, an ETC, an Artanis, and a Gazlow. We have Hammer, the Vikings, Uther, and Artanis. So there's no Stealther. So in looking at what I've got, Viciousness or Wolfheart is what I would be looking at. I'm probably going to go with Wolfheart. So you get to see what beginning laning looks like on him. So immediately I see an Artanis. Went in a little ham on the enemy Greymane there, simply because I knew Hammer was there and it looked like he was pegging him pretty well. Playing against a Greymane, the last thing you want to do is be relatively far back. And by the way, you will definitely go back to human form every time you mount. If I can get the range on here. Oh god, he just... Oh, that sucks so bad. He just kept going out of my vision. If I had the leap, that would have killed him. So pretty much what you want to do when you want... When you pick the talent that I did at level 1. You want to make sure that you have lots of stuff that you can auto-attack for a while. If you could sit there and auto-attack for a while, you see, 4 seconds. You don't want to burn that ability if there's not a lot around for you to auto-attack, or if you are running with a lot of people that just simply wipe everything out. It's really good if you're near an enemy base, or like a fight that we're about ready to get into here, where you could just peg away at a while and get a lot of value out of that. See here, definitely getting value out of activating that. And if I could catch up to him. So here I'm in Worgen form for a little bit. And I'm kind of staying this way. This way I can roll out if I get in danger. I can also roll in like that, and now I'm kind of screwed though, got completely walled out. Pretty close to a kill on the ETC though. So, stealth, inner beast causes basic attacks to restore mana. This is tends to be, like I said before, what I go for. I think I'll go for that. And we're going to lose this one, but it was pretty close.
A foe has summoned a mortar punisher.
So we almost baited him over. Here is, you know, another good time to activate Inner Beast. Oh, don't go back. I thought I was out of that. Oh, not good. Our front line is falling apart.
Well fought, heroes. We have slain the enemy's punisher.
See here, I jumped on him to get away, and I know full well that my next time would do that. So, if you're good with Karazim and you're used to using Karazim's abilities for mobility, you know, both getting in and out of trouble, then you're definitely going to have a leg up when you are playing Greymane. He's like part Vala, part Karazim. Here, activated Inner Beast again because I knew if I could just stand back here, I could plow away. And if any of these guys gets low, or just go in on that Brightwing, come back for Artanis, complete that kill. And see, now my speed is up again. Since I got a nice wall over here, I could get some love out of that. So I'm going to roll back to go back to human form so I could use my range. Here is the gathering power or increased basic attack range. Since they don't have a stealther, for the first time, I'm going to try Quicksilver Bullets. To see if I can kind of do the Lunara thing and be just a little bit further out. No consistent things to shoot at yet, so now is when I'm going to activate my inner beast. Probably should be able to get that ETC. Definitely in human form, use the environment to your advantage. If you have like Gazlow turrets on that, aim for the turret to get the splash behind them. He isn't the most hardy of assassins, however, he is not the weakest. After Lunara being the most recent hero, it is definitely nice to be on something that has a little bit of a thicker skin. The demons have summoned an army. It's also a pretty good assassin to counter early Sergeant Hammers. His ability to just kind of surprise jump in there with the Worgen transformations definitely catches some hackers out. See, there I activated my inner beast and didn't really have a lot of good auto attack time. So my cooldown was 8 seconds. Sadly, couldn't finish off the kill on that Artanis, which really sucked. Oh boy. Alright, so what we're going to do is we'll go ahead and pause until a little bit later on when I've got all the talents so you can see a little bit of beginning game, mid game, and end game. Alright, so we are back, losing 18 to 22 in kills, we're up a level, you can see my stats, highest hero damage right now, by a decent amount, and 9 kills, 7 assists, 3 deaths. So this is kind of a good area to activate my inner beast, should be able to get a lot of auto attacks in there. You can see the cooldown with that amount of work, 8 seconds. So that wasn't very good. I've actually gotten it to the point where the cooldown is 0. So, holding off on it. Now I can do it. Get a good amount of auto attacks here. Keep it refreshing. Keeping it up. Going in. See, it's down, but it was only down for about 3 seconds or so. And, I'll go with Unleashed again. If I can get around that. Nah, that Gazlo's too far. Where's our Uther? There's our Uther that I could get a heal. So, can activate it again. Getting free attacks on stuff. Nice, lots of free attacks. Keep it going, keep it going. And only 4 seconds. 4 seconds is probably the most common one. I feel happy if the cooldown is only 4. There's a kill on the... There you go. There's the double kill. And if there was, if you notice, it was still blinking there, that's because I had another 10 second window to cast that. So that was, that would have been up 3 times. There is a forward roll for offense, but now I'm getting pegged by the core. almost had body blocked the enemy Greymane from getting in and almost got a kill on that one, but not quite. So one thing that has to be realized when you are playing Greymane is that the reason why they give you more damage in the Worgen form is because that it's very tempting to play him safe. You know, play him as a Vala, play him as a Lunar, and just sit at the back line and, you know, not dive in. But in reality, his Worgen form is very good. And the good thing is that it gives you the escape. So let's see what he can do on a camp over here. So I'll start by throwing the cocktail. Activate rate mode. So that was definitely a very long duration. We'll look at the cooldown. Free. So that's what it's like to have a really large amount of basic attack time. You could get that to be right available again. So that's part of his tactical play there. Inner Rage is best used when you know you can sit and do something for a long period of time. These towers, maybe not always the best, because sometimes you have gaps or you have to move. I'll let them push up and I'll try to get us a Punisher. So since it's just me, I will activate rape mode over here. Hopefully, should be able to keep the chain going so that if I have a bit of a gap like that, I can reactivate it. And there it is. Winning match on Greymane. I haven't got a Hero of the Storm on him yet. Most of the new heroes I've tended to have a Heroes of the Storm on a first day. Even Lunaro, but I haven't managed to get that for him yet. So we'll look at the final stats. Got edged out by the Artanis in hero damage. Very, very interesting. Highest kills. This is the second time that I have done this in playing Greymane. Had a very Zeratul slash Nova stat distribution where the hero damage was okay, but had a ton of snipe. I mean, Jesus Christ, 12 kills. Considering we had 27 over there, that's a lot to have those kind of direct kills, especially for this kind of character. That's Nova territory right there. And deep in their core, just a little while ago, you saw what it was like to chain two of them together, but even 10 for this composition. Still would have been high. Siege damage, you know, average. XP contribution, a little low. And if we compare it to the enemy Greymane, I had very high hero damage for them. Very low siege. Died a lot. And he had the snipe factor over there, too. In comparing the final talents, he went inner beast duration and the ability damage causes the refresh. So this basically gives them a little bit of a longer gap before it fades off, but it's only 1 second. So this could mean that he maybe preferred Worgen form. He did Dark Flight, reducing damage of the attacks against him. I went still. Quicksilver Bullets, first time I did this, he decided to go, it was like Phase Shield. So he went Gathering Power. Not really a good choice for him. We both went Go for the Throat. I did the range. He did the Worgen basic attacks, reduce Razor Swipe's cooldown by a second. It's such a fast cooldown, and it's not the biggest charge in the world. I don't find a lot of value in this one. This, however, I do. I mean, range by 35% is very big. It allows for way more snipey kills and a much bigger rollout of trouble. Alpha Killer, basic attacks against heroes deal. So this is his giant killer. He went Ruthless Predator, basically expecting to be like Sunlock and Root and everything, which, yeah, there's Uther stuns, but there wasn't a lot of stuns over here. I don't think that would have been a lot of value for him. And then I did the Unleashed, which we saw two out of the three, and he didn't get the pick yet. So, there is the newest hero in Heroes of the Storm, Greymane. A lot of fun. I think he will definitely have a slightly longer life than Lunara. Lunara, basically, Cho'Gall, you know, we had his first week where he was very, very good. And then after that, Cho'Gall sucked. He's at the bottom of the win rates. Lunara is at the bottom of the win rates. Greymane, it remains to be seen. I'm going to look in the HOTS log and see if I can upload my stuff on him today. I think he, I don't know that he would do better than Cho'Gall in the first week, but I think he will do better than Lunara, and he will be played more than Lunara. His ability to play it safe and be in the back line and, you know, just plank away at high speeds is good. His ability to be aggressive in Worgen form, and basically almost be like an Illidan, just getting in there, mopping up, and then using disengage to roll out. He's going to cater to both play styles, but I think the most effective Greymane, kind of like a UFC fighter, is going to be somebody who has skills on both ends of the spectrum. Somebody who's good being backline like a Vala or Lunara, and somebody who also knows when aggression like an Illidan or a Zeratul is good. And you're definitely going to see people who prefer being in human form and people who prefer being a Worgen. I think the other Greymane was a little bit more Worgen than me, and I like just being in human form, hopefully sitting behind a tank and just, you know, plinking away and kind of using Worgen form for snipes and kills. I do think I need to maybe expand my usage of Worgen when laning. But due to the fact that unless you have a healer, he has no hit point sustain, there is something to be said about just, you know, standing behind your own minions, activating Inner Beast, and just, you know, hastily plinking away at things. So let me know down in the comments below what you think of him and which way you prefer doing him, whether you'd like to do balance, mostly human, or mostly Worgen. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Peace out, everybody.